With this video, we will see flag register of 8086, which is 16 bits in length. Flag is a single bit which either set to 1 or 0, informing the current state of the processor or controlling the functioning of the processor. Flag get automatically updated when any mathematical, that is arithmetic or logical operation get over. 8086 has got total 9 flags, which are divided into 2, conditional and control flags. This is the flag register of 8086, which is consisting of 6 conditional flags and 3 control flags. Conditional flags are also called as status flags since they represent the status of processor on execution of any mathematical operation. And these flags are carry flag, parity flag, auxiliary flag, zero flag, sign flag and overflow flag. Whereas control flags direct processor to take action depending on set or reset bit. And these flags are trap flag, interrupt flag and direction flag. Now starting with conditional flags, 0th bit from flag register represents carry flag. This flag is set to 1 when carry is generated on addition of 2 operands. With the given example, carry is not generated, so it is set to 0. In case of unsigned integer, on addition of MSBs of 16-bit operands, if carry is generated, then it indicates overflow, means the space is not sufficient to store the result. Second bit from the flag register represents parity flag. It gets set when any mathematical operation, which may be arithmetic or logical, results into even number of ones, which is also referred as even parity. In example, 2 operands are logically ANDed to give output with 2 number of 1s, which is even in nature. That's why parity flag is set to 1. Fourth bit from flag register is used to represent auxiliary flag. It is set to 1 when carry is generated on lower nibble addition. In case of binary coded decimal, that is BCD, if carry is generated on nibble addition, then decimal 6 get added to it to obtain valid BCD. Auxiliary flag makes processor aware of whether carry is generated on nibble addition or not. If carry is generated, then auxiliary flag is set to 1. Next comes zero flag. This flag is set to 1 when mathematical operation results in all zeros. In example, 2 operands are logically ANDed producing all zeros as a result, which leads to set zero flag to 1. Then here we go with the sign flag, which is the 7th bit from the flag register. It is set to 1 when operation results in MSB1 indicating result is negative. If it is 0, if MSB is 0, then it indicates that sign flag, that result is positive, and same get return with sign flag. Next comes the overflow flag. Overflow flag is set, then it informs that space is insufficient to store result corresponding to the mathematical operation. With the given example, two operands are added and from addition of MSBs, the carry is generated, which indicates that there is no space to store it and the corresponding overflow flag is set to 1. Now coming to the control flags. Control flags always control the action of processor or direct the processor whether to which action to follow. The first flag is the interrupt flag. If interrupt flag is 1, then processor either executes it or ignores it. It is depending upon the maskable or unmaskable nature of the interrupt. If it is maskable, then processor simply ignores the interrupt. But if it is unmaskable, then processor has to execute that interrupt. Next comes the trap flag. If trap flag is set to 1, then it puts the processor in single mode, single step mode. which is very helpful in the debugging. Instead of providing the result in one shot, the line by line execution is performed in the single step mode. Then third is the direction flag. Multibyte strings are stored in multiple but successive locations. So if direction flag is set, then string data is accessed from higher memory location to the lower memory location. And if it is zero, then it is accessed from lower memory location to the higher memory location. So this is all about flag register. Thank you.